Good morning, friends. I am Suraj Agrawal, and you are watching your favorite YouTube channel, Gardening is My Passion. Today, friends, I am going to tell about how to grow the gladiolus corms, that is commonly called gladiolus bulbs, that I am showing you. These are the bulbs. These are the not the bulbs. These are genuinely called. These are the corms. So, how can you grow the gladiolus flowers from these corms? So these are the gladiolus terms. The term came from Latin word gladius. Gladius means sword. The leaf looks like a sword. Tarwal in Hindi is called is tarwal. That's why it is called gladiolus. These are the flowers. These are the spikes of flowers of gladiolus. So many flowers comes. These are the some tube like flowers comes. And from the below side, they flower here, from bloom here from below. And from the upper side, they go along in this upper side. These are the beautiful gladiolus. And this comes in hundreds of colors, taking from pink to red to white to yellow to purple. Every color, hundreds of colors. And there are around 300 species of this gladiolus. And most of them are from Southern Africa and tropical Africa origin. So these are the flowers plants. And I am going to show you how to grow this gladiolus. This is the month of November. And around 20 days back, I just grown this gladiolus corms. These are the bulbs of gladiolus corms and grown. Let's have a look at that video. So 20 days back we have shown this, and let's come back again. And I'll show you. This is the second week of October. This is the starting of second week of October, and this is the time that you sow the corm or the bulbs of gladiolus. Gladiolus has a beautiful flowers that has big spike, a beautiful lots of flowers there, and every bouquet you find that cut flower of gladiolus, one or two pieces of cut flowers of gladiolus there in every bouquet. So this is the right time that you sow the bulbs. That is basically it's corm. So you grow the corm and grow the sprout there, and seedling, make the seedlings of this sprout. So not the seedlings, this is the sprout of these bulbs or the corms. So I am showing you how to grow it and how to make its sprouting. So let's see how I am doing. So friends, what is the difference between a bulb and a corm? So these are basically a corm, and these are the bulbs in the onion bulbs, and these are the corms. I am showing you the difference. And if I cut it at all, you see these are the all the fleshy leaves here. So these are the full of fleshy leaves. These are the bulbs. And in corm, if I cut it at all along in corm, I show you, I am sacrificing. This is all total solid structure. This is botanically, it is called corm, not a bulb. Still, in common word, we call it a bulb. So, I am showing you the growing of corm, how can we grow the corm. So, this is the right time, and I am showing you that sprouting has done here, just starting sprouting here. And this sprouting is already done, and this has already some sprouting has occurred here. And this corm, I am going to sow the corms here for gladiolus. And at the second week of October, and it will sprout in around 15 days. So I am going to show you how it can be grown in soil.
So and friends, this is the simplest method. How can you grow the corm of gladiolus? So if you are going to grow the corm, so I am showing you the tips. This is the tip of the corm. So when you are growing the this corm, you grow the tip portion in the upwards, and the basal portion, that is some flat portion, in the downwards. So you have to grow in the upward, that I am showing you. Just if it is taking you only the sand, dip it in around 1.5 inch and bury it with soil, cover it with sand 1.5 inch. And I am again, don't remove these scales, scale leaves, because these are protected from fungus attack. So I am altogether, I am burying here and covering with this sand. Just see, I am putting this upwards, the tip portion upwards, and the basal portion downwards. From here, the roots will come out. So I am burying it here, pushing it here, just 1/2 inch below the surface. Just cover it with sand. Once the process is over, just water it. Again, this is a mixture of compost and soil. Again, deep in 2 inch deep and cover it here. Just, you don't have to do much of the things, just make a hole and cover it. But friends, I advise you to grow in sand, because so here the fungal attack is more in soil. So in a sand, the fungal attack is far less in sand. So grow and make the sprouting up in the sand. Then after it is around 2 inch long sprouting, then you transfer it in soil. So these are the all the process I have done. Now I am going to water it. So friends, I have grown all the buds here, all the corms here, and watering properly. Full water. First time, water it full. And for the next time, just get it moist. Don't water it much for the next time. First time, you water it full, and next time. And keep it in, maximum time, keep it in open sunlight, so that the sprouting can occur in the open sunlight. But for the time being, and this is the rainy day is not over here, so I am keeping it in under some shade. So I am keeping it under shade for 5 or 7 days. If the rainy days are over, then I'll again keep it out in the open sunlight, and then the corm will sprout and some sprouting will occur. So thank you very much. And after 15 days, I'll show you the updates, what had happened and how the sprouting has. So friends, welcome back. You have just seen how we have grown all this in this, we have done in two ways. Once we have grown in sand only, and another was we have put here in somewhere the compost and soil mixture. So these are the growns after 20 days. You have seen, you just see how these are grown. These are the all the leaves here. So these are the 3 to 9 leaves, they come out, and after 1 month you will see beautiful spikes come out. And these types of flowers, hundreds of types of flowers are there. So hundred of colors, these type of flowers will come. So for the mixture, for the potting mixture, we are using 3 items, and you can do it your own. 3 parts of soil, 1 part of vermicompost or any kind of compost, and 1 part of cocopeat. So these are the mixture I am making. And now, after making the mixture, you grow this. And 1 pot, it is a 6 inch pot, will be growing 3 pieces from here. So have a look, I am potting it. Thank you. So friends, as you can see that we have grown 6 gladioli here and the corms, and now I am taking it out from below. So these are, I am taking it out, these are the all the roots, and I am putting here. So this is 6 inch pot, we are going to pot 3 pieces each here. You can see, these are the good roots, these are the coming, these are the spikes and ready. So I am putting it here also. Beautiful grown. So friends, this pot is my ready. And what we have grown in soil and vermicompost mixture, that I am showing you, this one, I am taking it out. So this one has been grown in soil and vermicompost, and I am putting it here. This was grown in soil and vermicompost mix. So friends, these are my ready, pots are ready, and now we will water it. And keep the all the plants in total sunshine, total full sunlight, and maximum sunlight as you can possible, because they love sunshine. Friends, now the time to water the plants. You just water the plants and they are ready. So within 1 month, the flower spike will grow. And you can see the flowers, beautiful flowers, myxepid, all the flowers. and the flower will stay for more than 1 month. The spike will stay with 1 to 2 months, spike will stay, and you can get maximum flowers. And now, friends, I am going to, if you don't like this process, if you don't use this process, you can grow directly to the potting mix that contains some vermicompost or any kind of compost and soil that I have done just 10 days back. Our assistants have done all this, and just have a look that how we have done this. So, and friends, we are implanting all these corms of these Gladiolus corms here. And the thumb rule is that if you are taking 4-inch pot, so you have to keep 2 there, and if it is a 6-inch pot, you give it 3 pieces, and if it is 8-inch pot, you implant there 4 corms. So depending on the size of the pot, you have to keep. This is a 6-inch pot, so we are implanting 3 pieces here. So this is the thumbnail. What is the size, give half of it the number of these corms. So these corms are ready, and we are implanting all these corms in these pots. So these are the corms we are getting implanted, and we are mixed here some of the sand, some soil, and some of the compost here. So we are implanting all this. These are all 6-inch pot. So in 8-inch pot, you implant 4 corms. 4 corms will be implanted. So I am showing you, these 4 corms are implanted in 8-inch pot and in equal distance. So that, and it cover it, just cover it at the top level, and just cover it with this soil mixture and potting mixture. So friends, now we are getting ready. All we have made and kept it here and watering it. First time you water it full, and you keep it moist all the time. So around 10 to 12 days it will take to germinate all these gladiolus corms, and these are ready. So after 10 days I'll meet again and show you the updates. Thank you.
So friends, welcome back. You just seen the how we have potted all these corms here. In 4-inch pot we have potted 1, 2, and in 8-inch pot we have potted 4, and in 6-inch pot we have potted 3. All these have germinated, and these are the direct sowing of these gladiolus bulbs in this direct in the pots. So you can grow in this way also, and this will in few days you will see the beautiful flower spikes grow out here. And friends, if you like my video, please give it a like, and if you want to share, please share with your near and dear ones. And if you have not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. I am going to give you lots of video and so many flowers and flowering plants. You will love it. And thank you very much. Thank you for being with us. So nice of you. Thank you.